see now. Turn off music. Still no. You need to spam it, I think. Alright, let's see. Still no ban face. Let's wait for the first pick first. Whoa, orange game one win.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
So let's see.
Radiant team back.
Oh, still songs, right?
Kind of
no. You close your song?
Yeah.
Dire team back.
So, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this is the Snitholic Soul Match between Paulus TN versus Vici Gaming Team Number 2. I'm Groove here with me. I have a best co-caster, Leoda, with me.
Yeah. Hi, everybody. We are with Groove today for the Snitholic Dota 2 Marathon Tournament. They have been made about 10 a.m. for today starting.
Remaining.
About to 10 a.m. today. So, Groove, continue with your casting.
Yep, alright, let's see. Vici Gaming banning out the Bat Rider as well with the Life Tealer, while Fall of CN banning out the Juggernaut as well with the Nyx Assassin and first pick, Magnus. So, Magnus being first pick, proper love, and Rubik is still in the pool. While Vici Gaming 2, Team 2, and Vici Gaming picking up their Leshrac as a first pick. It's quite weird for me. What do you think, man? So this is their combos. Shadow Demon and Leshrac Disruption as well with the Speed Earth. And yeah, we're gonna see a lot of roaming with this lineup, I think. Yoda, what do you think?
What
do you think about their lineups?
Yeah, so Paulus already picked the Magnus. Magnus already got the his RP that can catch all 5 heroes in that area. And BG already get the Shadow Demon and Leshrac. Common combo, the usual combo that will be made by BG.
And yep.
Yeah, with their disruption and the follow up with Split Earth. The normal combo.
Yep.
Any team in the world.
Yep, it's definitely the current best heroes for supports. Well, Fall of CN picking up the Alchemist as well, the Keeper of the Light. Alchemist being one of the heroes that currently being picked a lot on the Chinese team as well with the Asian meta game. A bit Alchemist with that Gribble Grid. I mean, Gribble Grid. That can really boost up its farm as well with Keep of the Light, one of the best supports, one of the best nuker, and one of the best heroes that can do globals gank with his recall. So quite gonna say, oh, it's an anti mage and just about to say Phantom Lancer, so it's not gonna be a Phantom Lancer in this game. Instead, anti mage gonna be a carry for Vici Gaming too. Nothing much, split push, and with most of the damage he can do, he can deal. So anti is not a bad choice for this game. Fall of CN. Oh, Vici Gaming banning out the Rubik is really Oh, nice. I'm not pretty sure why. I thought they're gonna pick Ruby. Okay.
Rubik, because he can steal the RP from the Magnus.
Yeah, so but instead they are banning out the Rubik and well for Obsidian banning out the pet Templar Assassin, I mean, as well with keep Queen of Pain. So yeah, I'm just really I'm not pretty sure why they would banning out that a Rubik maybe might for they're going for some heroes that don't want his skill to be still. Maybe they're gonna pick, let's say, maybe not pretty sure, maybe a Tidehunter, maybe, no, I'm not sure. But Rubik definitely being banned out by VG Gaming as well with Sanking now.
For the streamer, this is VG second team.
Ten
This is not
seconds
the
remaining.
VG first team that got ZSMJ. This
Five
is the
seconds
second
remaining.
team for VG. And VG is still not getting their
Scout time.
mid laner hero. And for now, already banned two mid lane hero. There is Templar Assassin and Queen of Pain. Maybe we will see another mid hero, such as Tinker or Invoker.
Yep, let's say, but they are gonna be the favor of VG Gaming as well as Sword for Love in this matchup. So yeah, this is the show match. They might be doing some new strategy in this game by looking at the drop right now. It's currently the same meta game, the same drop that been used most of the tournaments in the current meta game. So nothing much. Anti-mage with the split push capabilities as well with that disruption that can deal that can make another illusion for the anti-mage. Definitely gonna be up. Yeah, I just realized that with the Lesra as well. Yeah, lineup is too looking forward for the pushing strategy with that disruption on anti-mage as well with the Diabolic Edict from Lestrade that can melt down the towers. And the last ban from Fall of Xian is gonna be Kunkka. Not pretty sure, yeah, but might be this is gonna. I'm not because we saw some pro teams game using anti-mage as their off lane, even though that's not the best strategy you can go. But yeah, we saw some teams using anti-mage as off laner, so banning out this Kunkka to deny their combos with that disruption as well the split earth. Am I thinking about that? But I'm not
Ten
pretty sure VG
seconds
Gaming 2
remaining.
gonna go for an off lane anti-mage. This might be they're gonna be the
Five seconds remaining.
trial hero. What do you think, man? What do you think?
Oh, they are banning the Bane Elemental. And they are choosing the Clockwork. Maybe the Clockwork will be the
Offlaner.
offlane. Yeah, offlaner with his Rocket. Rocket Flare to get some farm. And
Yep.
maybe we will see the last support hero from Fallout. What do you think? Which hero they will pick for them?
Let's see.
10 seconds
Not
remaining.
pretty sure, but yeah, but the banning of a Bane,
Five
I'm
seconds
not sure
remaining.
why. Maybe they're just gonna deny it. They're gonna pick something that needs this then the one to be disabled, and that's gonna be their choice from VG Gaming too. That's it. Yeah, looking at the draft, the four heroes now, it's really showing that they are going for fast push game. With
Yeah.
the disruption on anti-mage as well with the Darkseer Iron Shell and the Vacuum. Well, Clockwork and Jakiro now. Jakiro gonna be a favorite. Whoa, is that one big fast drop with the
Oh,
Visage?
yeah. Do
Sage gonna
Visage will be the alt mid laner for the VG?
might be, yep. Oh, let's see, yeah, that's gonna be the best choice they have now. Maybe we're gonna see some new strategy lanes, but not sure. Maybe Wizard's gonna go mid as well with Darkseer off lane and the trialing with an anti-mage. But whoa, I thought I have some internet connection now. It's
Prepare for battle.
okay now. So I'm gonna go for the Radiant lineup and Fall Leaf. We got Fall Leaf 8k on the Magnus, KYO using the Alchemist, and Tio Henkai using the Keeper of the Light. I'm not pretty sure what this name is. Using the Clockwork as Zippo using the Jakiro. Naruto on the dire lineup, we got Tutu using the Anti-Mage, LHRG using the Darkseer, Kira using the Visage, Pertihao using the Shadow Demon, and Sua Lee using the Leshrac.
And for VG, they are using the Anti-Mage for S, offlaner.
Yep. That's what I say, I saw some teams using this Anti-Mage as offlane. So yeah, they're using him as again, and gonna be a trialing with Visage as well. Darkseer on the mid lane versus Magnus. Yeah, the Magnus gonna have some bad time now with the Iron Shell as well. He's newly top lane, gonna see. I think that's just some harassment from Anti-Mage. Oh, he got the mana burn on level 1, he should not tell. Another quick pause from the Anti-Mage. Leoda, some of the Weaver saying about the overlay.
Yeah, I already fixed it.
Alright, okay.
Maybe a bit delay.
So, who the guys in on Dota TV, if our voice is shattering, breaking, it's about the servers we are using. We are using Perfect World servers, so might be, and we are not using some VPNs or anything, so you can tune in to our stream, live stream. It's not on delay at all, so you can see better on this live stream. As Dota TV, you have 2 minutes delay. You can watch live on stream. It's at twitch.tv/LiodaVivo. It's LiodaVevo. So they're gonna try him with an alchemist. Oh, look at this alchemist sets.
Wow, the newest.
The newest set. Nice sets over there, nice set, man. I think if the helmet, I mean the headset and helmet alchemist, the goblin something, using the other set's helmet, the Batman set something I got.
And the game is starting.
Yep, the game continues.
So we will.
They're just gonna throw with Shadow. And Shadow are picking up the Haste Rune. Oh, they saw this. They got these wards over here. So
yeah.
They saw everything. Just gonna block the cam. And I thought Sentry's been dropped.
And Deep Ward already put in the bottom lane by.
Wow, really aggressive. Yeah, really aggressive wards over there. But yeah, with the Visage lineup, you can really go really offensive. Visage with that Soul Sumption. Whoa, I thought not gonna land on him. Really, really aggressive there, both of the team. Even the Alchemist got in his turn, Untribal Concussion on level 1. Mid lane, we're gonna see. That's here having some good time with the Iron Shell harassing Magnus.
What's that?
Oh. No, I'm not too sure. Some Spanish flying it. Well, in bottom, we're gonna see disruption on Jack Hero as well with unstable conclusion charge. Jack Hero gonna let die to Dark Cherryman on first light while Kira still doing damage to Kyo, and nice. Split up, been dropped there, and Cherryman gotten a double kill. So yeah, just been really offensive here. Oh, got a blast as well, been dropped.
There was nice strategy at the bottom lane with the disruption of Shadow Demon with the follow up by the spirit from Leshrac to kill both of heroes from Polaf at the bottom lane.
Yep. I'm gonna see Kira taking a lot of damage from the Hentai using the Quartzel. Illuminate doing a lot of damage over here, and top lane, the carry. Anti-mate sitting at 8 last hits now. Not that bad. Yeah. Not that bad for an off lane and main damage.
And the mid lane, both of hero not have any difficulty to take the last hit.
Yep. Iron Shell and Yarika with the shockwave.
Yeah.
Both of them doing pretty decent top lane. We're gonna see Cox and anti mage, nothing much. Burning, whoa, no mana at all. Now, clockwork. Bottom lane, Cuttle Glass, land. No, not gonna land on Kera. Oh, Cuttle? No, I thought they're gonna go with them.
Because.
So, what is interesting, man?
With yeah, because you're riding here. Yeah.
They can saw everything over here.
They can saw everything and the cult cell in this area.
Look at I think, but this ward, I'm not really a favor for this ward. Oh, yeah. It hurt the destruction be land on the alchemist. Oh. Split earth. No, soul shamshan be used. A nice ice bat from.
And one.
No, stun not gonna
from.
Die.
Yeah.
Not gonna die. Nice ice bat from.
Nice ice bat from Zippo. Nice defensive. Yeah.
Yep. Squally, you need to back off now. But this both of these sentries over here not gonna see each other. I think maybe no.
No.
Out of range.
Out of range.
I think around here. Middle tower is under attack. And then nothing. A rune fight. No. Oh, let's see. Yeah, you push the top in Dota TV, right?
Yeah.
Alright, and top lane and teammates getting some decent farm there, sitting on second on the last hit and deny chart now.
It's 24 last hit. And followed by Clockwork, there is 12, just 12 last hit at the top lane.
Yep.
Clockwork have difficulty in the top lane to get the last hit.
Yep, and make sure that.
And the bottom lane, one disruption, one spirit from the Lashrek. Doom!
Yep,
and the alchemists have been killed by the Lashrek.
They want more, no. No, they're not gonna get more. Can I spin down? Who got a kill just now? Lashrek got
yeah,
a kill.
Yeah, Lashrek. So there is comfortable for the BG at the bottom lane to kill the Ultimus. So Ultimus yep. Have a bad day at the bottom lane to get the last hit. And the Ultimus not up one skill in his Gravel Grid to get the last hit.
Yeah. I just realized that I want to say that it's not really awkward. I mean, not a decent build for an alchemist. So alchemist, you want that go gravel grids to farm out as fast as you can. So I'm not pretty sure why I need extra levels on the unstable concoction. Or I can just max out that and can just cover up his farm. So yeah, pretty weird build from Fallout. Let's see here, huh? Full of Q. And they're just doing some single pulls, not a double pulls or stack pulls. As with this, they're just gonna push on the lanes and giving BG extra experience.
So, at the mid lane, one RP from Magnus. You want Ice Friends from Jakiro to kill the Darkshear and the Mil-In. And it was a nice setup and Clockwork already get the
message. Yeah, about that. About that, but today we're gonna see Deception on as well with and so Deception, no, Cotoblast not gonna get anyone. As Flashrite got the last hit on the Alchemist with his Devilic Addict. So yeah, bottom lane we're gonna see a lot of progression from them. And Alchemist is being taken down a lot of time. So not a decent thing to happen to a carry for a game.
Yeah, he's already died for three times.
Well, Antimage is still not that bad, as well as still stacking.
Stacking the Ancient, stacking the NC.
Yeah, stacking the Neutrals. So, doing some creeps. The lane has now the lane switch. Magnus going top as well with Clockwork going mid. So let's see if it is switching, lane switching, gonna do something better for Love in his rune from the Clockwork, and a rotation from Shadow Demon as well as Restrack Smoke to the top lane. So we're gonna see some aggression, we're gonna see some kills on this Magnus. He still have his Skiver and 20 seconds. Oh, the smoke! The smoke will reveal drop Deception on the Magnus as well. Best. This, yep, split up, Anti-Mage doing what he can do with that right clicking, and he got the last 6 and off him. Nice deep reaction from Paulov.
Three triple to the top lane.
And hook shot, where's the hook shot? No hook shot yet. No Shadow Demon, you should be careful there. And hook shot on the Shadow Demon Cox. Anti-Mage is there, dealing his damage. Shadow Ward, what? Going drop over there, and as well with Void, Mana Void being used.
Oh, nice block by Darkshear!
That Battery Assault doing a lot of.
Yeah, it's nice block.
Nice play by them. That hook shot cost his life.
Yeah. He should not.
Yeah, he should really be there now. Anti-Mage picking up his Perseverance. Bottom lane, and now the Alchemist being left alone with his Sage on level 6 while he on level 5 without any levels on the Gravel Grid. So now this is not the really actual bit of and not really recommended for Alchemist user. Alchemist is known and be picked for his Gravel Grid. So if you're not using the Gravel Grid to the max, so why should you pick an Alchemist?
Yeah. And to rotate up by 2 support from the VG to the bottom lane. Maybe we'll see one more die from Alchemist.
Yeah, both team smoke up top lane as well, bottom lane as well. Let's see who's gonna get the kills first.
And one TP to the bottom lane. Yeah.
Work. Smells something fishy and TP out to help. Now disruption on the Alchemist.
Oh, one disruption.
Split has been used as a Clockwork hookshot to help. Clocks being used. So Champion on the Alchemist. Alchemist taking a lot of damage from there as well with the unstable concussion we used. Bin land on Kira and they are not gonna get the kill. Well, that happened in top lane. Gonna see aggression on the anti-man. And the RP being used as well. So yeah, nice well played by.
Well, at the mid lane, Daxia already get the last hit.
Towers, yeah.
Tower, yeah. Radiant's middle tower
is under attack. So yeah, both team doing some aggression on the both lane, but nothing much. Well, that said, there's now they're ganking bottom and top lane. So just doing what he can to get the tower down as fast as he could.
Okay, we will see the middle lane.
Yep, maybe I can be used the disruption as well. Versus the split up, and the split up being used on the Clockwork, and this is the death of the Clockwork.
Easy kill for the VG with the spirit from the Leshrac. Nice timing by them, by him.
Yep, as well with the double iron shell just now, dealing a lot of damage. Top lane, Anti-Mage trying to defend his tower. Cotoblast will be shockwave, but shockwave only hits on him, taking a lot of damage. He got one levels only on his spell shield. Whoa! Nice bit of that.
Yeah.
So guys who are watching on Dota TV, is our voice. If our voice is chattering, please switch to our Twitch channel as we are using Chinese server, so we are not from China. Chinese servers, I mean, so it's gonna shatter a bit. Switch to our Twitch channel live stream. It's on twitch.tv/leodelvivo. And see, top bottom lane, gonna see TP rotation from Jakiro. Kotl and Clockwork is there to assist as well. Alchemist from. Oh, I heard that hookshot on. Nice disruption, but he's still dancing over there with the assault, and he's dead. He should just disrupt himself just now.
But if he disrupt himself, he still will survive.
Yeah, but it still can. Might be something epic might happen. But yeah, both ways, just gonna die. But without disrupting himself, just gonna die faster. Whoa, anti-mage. Okay, it's the double lion shell now. Magnus doing what he can to defend this tower. Clockwork don't have his hookshot for another 25 seconds.
And Visage in the good shape at the bottom lane.
Yep. Cutting his, trying to get his mechanism up soon. I think if you go for the cheap medallion build, yep, it's gonna be really really pain for this alchemist, as he can just summon slow and use his medallion to deal a lot of damage with his familiars. Magnus doing nothing, waiting for the runes, and the rune gonna spawn at bottom. It's gonna be an illusion rune. Top lane pushing, and Vanguard is up on Darkseid now.
And Magnus, or just 200 away from his Kaelin Dagger or Blink Dagger. Maybe we will see a Blink RP will be made by Magnus. And the bottom lane.
Yep, we're gonna see the split urban lock been dropped on the Alchemist.
And yeah, Alchemist already been killed. Shot
on two. And Shadow Demon as a recall, 9 Macro Fire being used as well with Darkseid.
Nice Darkseid ultimate.
Yep, let's see. And Ice Bar being dropped as well. Oh, I heard that RP being used on the last rack, and that gonna be that last rack, one dead last rack. And oh, the familiar giving a lot of bounty on them. Not doing quite well VG there, but still ultimate top lane farming well. Getting his Claymore up as well as 500 and getting a last hit on the tower now. So looking at the gold graph now. It's 5k as well as experience. It's 2.2 experience both of Dire's side, both on VG's side. So yeah, they're doing quite well even though they lost the last fight just now. What do you think, man? About the Alchemist?
Alchemist.
Yeah.
Alchemist have a bad day at the bottom lane. He should get the Gravel Grid in the early game so he can farm a bit faster.
A lot of faster, I think.
Yeah. And he still don't get any core item like Midas. Oh, maybe. And one hookshot to the bottom lane. Oh, one vacuum from Darkseid, and they will die.
Yep, and nothing much. Just...
And Alchemist already TP'd to the bottom lane to help his teammate to defend the tier 1 tower at the bottom lane. Alchemist should not keep it to the bottom lane. He should just stay at the at the top lane to get some farms. To farm up his Midas, maybe. Or maybe Vanguard. Because he still not get his core item.
So yeah, let's see what they're going to do for Love. No portraits up yet on the Alchemist. And for man's bottom, PJ trying to get this tower while MT is farming out this battle fury. I think he got this now. Yeah, he got this now on the courier sending. Bottom lane, whoa, quarter blood may use. TP, Jakiro is dead, Cookshot on too, but just Cook managed to get one. Ice Pipe been dropped on too. RP on one only, but let's see who's gonna go down and Mech5 been used as well. Anti-Mage is here, Anti-Mage is trying to help his teammate. Skiver out,
Nice dodge by Shadow Demon, but it's not gonna help him from surprise. Ooh, one blind light. Blinding light from KLTL. Not to help Magnus survive, but he's still not survive from the war.
Yep, let's see. And Alchemist is on the run now. Teammate trying to help, but no, not gonna be enough. Let's see if they're going for that. No, they're just gonna back off. Trying to get his third one. Oh, Alchemist. Still wanna get a kill. No mana void, no stuns. So yeah, he's just gonna TP away to safety. Anti-Mage, nice reaction over there. He saw his teammate need some help, TP out. TPing in and just doing a lot of damage and get managed to win the war. And Jakiro not a place to be there. Just gonna back off safety. And this, they're just gonna claim this tier 1 tower.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
And for sure, Anti-Mage already get his BKB and 1600 gold. All and one disconnect from Leshrac. One more time, he's disconnect from this game. And this was a bad day for Ultimate. He's already died for fifth time.
Yep.
Yeah, it was a bad day for Carry. And Magnus already up his Blink Dagger.
Yup, so let's see what they are going to do now.
Fallerf need Alchemist to be farm up as fast as he can.
Yeah, but I don't think
level, yeah.
He can do it for now. I'm not pretty sure, but let's see if they're going to do some comebacks or not. But with this, Alchemist is really, really underpowered now. He's sitting below the supports. Even the supports is higher CS for me.
Yes. Just 37 to 9 to 40.
Yep. Let's see what they have in the courier now. Anti-Mage is trying to get his Vladimir now.
Vladimir, yeah.
Yep.
Oh, Vladimir in the courier.
The courier.
Smeeville. So
let's see a rotation, full team rotation to the top lane now. Oh, they're just gonna back off. They know something is fishy going on. Just gonna back off safety, not gonna contest this. So yeah man, this game is not doing, Polar is not doing really well.
Yeah, with the under farm of their carry at the bottom lane.
Yeah, under farm Alchemist. 1.9k gold up on him now, but yeah, let's see on the network. Network holder 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He's sitting on the 5th. The net holder. It's not that well. Let's see, Magnus. New dagger, nothing much. Magnus. Oh, nothing much. Let's see, that's here. I mean, yeah, that's here. Managed to got him angered and now going for the pipe, I guess. With that cloak being quick. Squally. Drums, maybe two braces now. Braces gaming. Mechanism is up on research while Sherryman nothing much. Not just the warding, the wards. And they know now. They are in Roshan pit. But let's see if they are going to contest. Yeah, I see some rotation over there.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Oh, one.
Tactical pulse.
Heavy made by VG.
top people also over there.
Yeah. Maybe we will see the Blink RP will be made by Madness.
Yep, let's see. Or maybe just Hookshot first to initiate and using Madness as follow-up. That's it, what they are going to do. But this timing on Pulse is really, really bad. Even the Kotal is casting something. It's recalling someone. It's recalling.
Yeah, maybe recalling the Jakiro in top lane.
So Alchemist is trying to get his, what the hell is this, traps and a Claymore, maybe Claymore. Going for the Shadow Blade soon.
Yeah.
Soon, but I mean soon is
gonna take,
by saying soon is taking a, gonna take a lot of time. It's gonna be a long time. Even though he got his River Grids now, I think if he got it earlier, it wouldn't be this bad for him. But yeah, good thing they have the Magnus. With that empower that I can cleave. Good thing. This might have the chance, might have the chance to do some comebacks in this game, but let's see.
Some of the viewers want me to do 360 pixel to my streaming. So if I gonna be a partnership with Twitch TV, maybe I could.
Yep. It. And the game resume, let's see what's gonna happen now. Hookshot, where's the hookshot? And hookshot been used on them. What been dropped over there? No, Roshan and team is gonna pick then. There it is, and now Pink in to do some damage, and the one gonna die first is Lockwork. And let's see, the chase is continuous. And team is chasing the Jakiro, nice as part over there. And TP out. Oh, nice TP out.
No vacuum from Darkshire.
Yeah, he just used just now. So yeah, he know they don't have any stuns. Whoa, anti-mage, nice blinding light from the console. Illuminate. Boom. And anti-mage claim the tier 2 tower. Oh, and Shadow Demon is on trouble now. And Magnus got a kill. Just slightly overextend Shadow Demon over there.
Yeah. He should not be there. Because his teammate already back out.
Just back off the city.
Yeah. And Timesh will meet his Yasha. Maybe he will go for Menta.
Yep, definitely. And top lane. Alchemist using ultimate.
Alchemist, yeah. Do he capable to kill the anti-mage at the top lane?
No, the anti-mage dealing a lot of damage.
Maybe he will blink out. Oh, nice blink out.
Oh, nice rocket over there. Blink out. And no, it's just gonna be some harassment. Not gonna be a kill. So let's see if... I'm not sure why really Alchemist doing really there. Want to get some kills on the enemy. No, he can't, just harassing.
And he's already got his Shadow Blade. Finally.
Yep, finally. 23 minutes and a Shadow Blade as well with threat. And we're gonna see a rotation with smoke and gem from the Shadow Demon to bottom lane. 4 men and they drop a ward and they see. Whoa, disruption.
Nice vacuum.
On that Jakiro as well, split out that one, the other side. We see the chase on the Kotal and Soul Assumption gonna clean the kill. Immediate buyback from the Kotal. Anti-mage blink in, playing really aggressive over there, the link.
Yeah, he needs to blink out because Magnus RP is up. Maybe he will see one blink RP.
Yep, let's see.
One blink RP.
No, Cox, no. Petra Assault, no, nothing. Oh, where's the Magnus? No blink. And Clockwork died with no follow up.
No follow-up by Magnus.
Yep, no follow-up. Quite misplay and quite miscommunication, I think. from Fallout team. Should be not that bad for a decent play team. So I think, yeah. The score is 10 to 60 now. While sitting on the top network is Anti-Mage, followed by Darkseid as well with Research. So yeah, top 3 network holder is on the VG team. But let's see on the gold graph again. The gold graph, whoa, is going to 11k gold rate and experience is 7.5k experience rate put on VG team. VG team, I mean.
Yeah. And Visage already got his Necromicon.
Necronomicon, yeah. Whoa, we really are pushing build from them. Necronomicon.
Pushing with game heavy made by VG.
Where's the pipe? Whoa, 4k gold on the ducks here.
Whoa, 4k. You're still not buying anything.
I don't know, but I was thinking this might be a Radiance. Might be, I'm not sure.
Might be, yeah.
We less see ducks here using a Radiance because you can buy other items that is really useful for his teammates. As like that pipe, as a pipe could be good decent choice with that macrofire as well with the Cortal Blast. But let's see what VG Gaming gonna go. But this LHRG gonna go for his item build. Anti-Mage picking up his ultimate op on his dash now.
And he just 300 away to complete his Manta style.
Yep. And let's say the egg is gonna pop up soon, another 1 or 2 minutes setting.
It's about 5 minutes. 5 to 6 minutes. And Anti-Mage already got his Manta style. And it will give him more pushing power.
Yep. TP out.
TP out to the bottom lane. Maybe too defensive this bottom lane.
Not gonna give any free towers to the follower. 3.2k gold on the Alchemist. But yeah, Darkseid is really for him. Let's see, it's better than him. Oh, he's picking up a Mystic Staff now.
Maybe we will see a...
We're gonna go Shiva for Shiva.
Yeah, Shiva Gat.
Oh, I have some internet connection problem. Okay, I'm back.
Yeah.
Shit. So yeah man, this game is really about pushing.
Pushing and pushing from VG.
Yeah, he got his Shiva gun now. One Fat Ducks here. Can go for a troll mode. Can go for a luxury item that can benefit himself only instead of helping teammates. This really shows how
the game
is going.
Stacking there.
One RP.
But it's not his edges.
So hold that push. Let's see. Chase continues. No, they're just gonna back off. Nice pick up from the dark.
Yeah. Oh, nice disruption to Alchemist. Do Alchemist will dead.
Yep, Alchemist is on the run now while the other side. Jakiro being killed by Lightra as well. That's got a kill on the Keeper of the Light. No, that Alchemist just gonna back off to safety.
There was a waste ultimate from Magnus. Actually, yeah, because he used his RP on the.
Even the hook had been used.
Yeah. Two ultimate to get the Anti-Mage.
Yep, and his teammate just came to help him.
And six Anti-Mage in the field.
The tower is really melting the barracks. Yeah, so melting with the Necronomicon as well being used. Now they're just gonna back off to safety.
They already got their first Rex at the bottom lane.
29 minutes and a Rex. Let's say jump on the Shadow Demon Anti-Mage. Looking around, now just gonna be made to farm some up and pushing soon. Go for a divine place, divine place.
Divine place. Maybe he will go for butterfly because he already got 3.2k.
Yeah, you don't need a tank I think in this game.
Because Alchemist yes. not that tank, and Clockwork too not that tank to being killed. It is easy kill because Clockwork don't have any core item. It just two braces. Clockwork is not tank enough to tank the their team, this team to.
And it's off.
Yep, let's see. It's quite hard for them to come back. Advance pick from the Lashra as well. Going for BKB, man. Lashra is going for BKB. When a support got a BKB, it's really show you how the game is going.
Yeah.
Yep, it's 15k gold mark as per the experience on the experience and gold craft. So like I said in my past cast, whenever the craft reach 50k, it's likely hard for a comeback. It's most likely the other team that have the 15k advantage is really the winner for the game. But yeah, this is not a decent team. This is for the versus Virgie. I see if they're going to do some comebacks in this game. Oh, I heard a lot of TP there. Anti-Mage is just gonna back off to safety now.
And Anti-Mage already got his river. Maybe he will go to Heart of Terrace.
I just gonna don't want to race anything. Just gonna go for the safer build, the different build, Heart of the Rust build. I can give him some more tankiness, and so he still can benefit from it. Heart of the Rust recipe is up.
Yeah.
And let's see what the people say on the Alchemist. Oh, I saw Kuras. I think now, even though he's under farm, now catching up. But I think if he get his Agrippa Glitch in the early stage, it's mostly gonna be a comeback now. And the top 3 Nanti network holder is. Oh, I heard the RP over there. RP being used on it. That's the only anti missiling there to get the kill. That's it. Shima has been used. Vacuum. Rest the wall. No wall being used up. Yep. Oh, it's full chaotic over there. I'm not pretty sure what is happening. Alchemist is on the run now. And Demonic Purge will use, and this is bad of him. Spotlight. Not really out of
and
the range.
And GG call have been made by Magnus. So, yeah. VG Gaming already won this show match. They have been made by Natolic TV. So, we will see
you guys.
Yeah.
Yep. We will see you guys on game number 2. The next game, I mean. So, let's see. Bye, guys.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.